Hello, English Journal readers, and welcome to our January 2015 edition of Ask Kimberly. This month, one reader asks, I'm thinking about leaving the company that I work for and starting my own business, but I don't know where to begin or what kind of business to start. Would you give me some advice? This is a dream that we share. Long ago, when I was working at Hewlett-Packard, I too dreamed of starting my own business, but I had no idea where to begin. I knew nothing about starting a business. Now, this year, I'm celebrating my 14th anniversary of running Weefling Consulting, one-person consulting business, doing business all over the world. Now, Weefling Consulting wasn't my first business, and I made many mistakes along the way, and there was a lot of discouragement and times I wanted to give up. I'm hoping that you can learn from my experience on this winding path from wage slave to successful business owner. So, here's where to start. Start small. Approximately 500,000 new businesses are started in the U.S. every month. Now, nearly 80% of those are one-person businesses, like auto repair shops, bakeries, or hair salons. These are businesses that only one person is working in. Now, most of those go out of business pretty quickly, but that's okay. It's an experiment. Think about what kinds of business you could start. Just a one-person business that you could operate all by yourself. It could be something simple. There are many possibilities. My advice, start your business before you quit your job. Getting your business going while you still have a steady paycheck will reduce your stress a lot. When I was at HP, a lot of my colleagues told me that I was really good at career coaching, resume review, and helping them with job interview preparation. They said, Kimberly, you should start your own business. So I did. I was still working full-time at HP, but I started printing these business cards saying, Kimberly Weefling, career coach, giving them out to my friends, and they just believed I was in business. And I operated that career coaching business for several years before I left my steady job. You've got to explore and experiment. Here's a step-by-step process that can help you bootstrap your business from a small one-person business to a larger business with less risk and less investment. You can quickly gain plenty of information. Even if you don't make money or a lot of money, you'll learn so much that will be helpful when you do finally start your successful business. First, do your homework. You've got a lot to learn about starting, running, and growing a business. There are plenty of resources, reading books, taking classes, interviewing other business owners. Next, brainstorm. With yourself and maybe another friend, think of all the different ways that you could start a business. What are your skills? What are your experiences? What are the things that you're great at? What are you interested in? What do people say you're wonderful at? And see if those businesses might be something that you could start in your spare time. Now be sure to include some ridiculous ideas. Remember FedEx, that famous successful global company? Well, that business proposal was harshly criticized when it was first proposed in a business class. Seek feedback. Ask people for advice. Ask people you trust. Please don't ask your most negative friend. Ask people who could encourage you. Don't listen to any discouraging comments at this moment. There's plenty of time for that later. Next, experiment. Choose a business from your list that you would operate for the next 3 to 6 months. It's just an experiment. It doesn't mean you're going to sell your house and use all of your family's wealth to start this business. You're just going to do an experiment. Pick a business name. Create a slogan. Create a logo for yourself. Print up some business cards. Professional looking business cards are inexpensive, even free sometimes. Start giving those cards out to people. Spread the word about your business. Here's what I did. I called up some people I knew and I said, I'm starting my career coaching business. I'd like to offer you a free hour of coaching in exchange for your feedback on my process. I'd also appreciate referrals to other people who could benefit from my services. Now, I did that for 15 or 20 people, and each person I did for free. But don't tell people you're working for free. Get their testimonials, get their referrals. Put up a website. Tell about all your delighted clients. Treat these non-paying clients as if they're paying full price. Then use them as your champions to grow your business. You have to market your business. Market it more widely using a simple brochure, could be a website, periodic email newsletters. That can be a great way to get started for very low cost. Talk about your business as if it's already successful. Don't say, oh, well, I'm doing a few clients, but they're not paying me. No, you say, well, last week I met with 3 clients and 2 of them got better jobs as a result of working with me. And here's the testimonials to prove it. You never have to mention what people are paying you. Even today, some of my work pays a lot and some of it is free for pro bono causes. I don't tell people that I work for free. When I work for free, I still do a great job as if I'm being paid full price, because that's what professionals do. Now, keep in mind, it's not going to go smoothly at all times. Learn from your mistakes. There's something called pivot. My business is going this direction. It's not working. I may have to pivot to go in another direction. That experiment doesn't work perfectly. Pivot again. Don't give up. Failure is just deciding not to try again. And failure, by the way, is a step on the path to success. As with my new venture, mistakes and failures are inevitable in yours. But success is the reward for refusing to give up. Leaving a steady paycheck, it takes courage. But this bootstrapping method that I just shared with you can reduce your risk and increase your chances of success. Like me, it might take you 10 years to become successful, but I assure you, if I can do it, you can too.